some 13,000 newly unearthed cultural relics were discovered in a new round of excavation at China's ancient ruin site, Sanxingdui. For this new round of excavation, cutting-edge technologies have been applied for the exploration process as well as restoration. Now, I am in the museum for a Sanxingdui Ruins cultural relic restoration. Here, visitors can closely watch restoration activities. And today, we meet an excellent restorer here. Let her take us around and help us to better understand the technologies for bringing ancient relics back to the life.
我从事文物修复大概二十年左右嘛，2003年就到博物馆了噻。从最简单的嘛开始修陶器啊、瓷器啊，然后慢慢慢慢接触青铜器。我现在清理的是那个山河坑的一个兽头，这个兽头的是个残件。现在我们对它清理工作呢，就首先要对它这个器型器物进行拍照，测量它的尺寸。 记录好以后，然后就，然后观察它这个器物有没有啥子其他的特征，比如说这一件器物，它还是这儿的，你看比较黄这个地方，也可能是一种颜料附着在上面，附着上面呢，我们就要通过那个显微镜来对它进行观察。现在修复工作呢，就必须要还是，比较有科学的修复嘛，就是多观察多看它上面有没有信息。
以便于以后这些科研工作者呀，这些，更好的对这个文物进一步的研究工作做好基础嘛，反正。The
archaeological team excavated more than 400 ivory tusks from four sacrificial pits, number 3, 4, 7, and 8. Many ivory relics remain intact but have become very fragile after thousands of years of burial, making it difficult to retrieve and restore.
我们为啥是说叫文物医生？之前我们修象牙的时候就叫牙科医生呢，对它一个清洗，清洗以后就对它有保护，后头又对它加固，保存的年限更长啊。
To preserve DNA and other protein information contained in the relics, the bronzes should be stored in a state of low oxygen and low temperature, while the ivory pieces should be well placed in cold storage.
我们现在就是在三号洞窟，就是存放象牙的那地方，基本上就是从那个基石坑那边的出土的文物、出土的象牙，我们就。 会拉到这个地方，这个洞窟里面来。这个洞窟的温度一般是控制在5度左右，湿度是90%左右。我们必须穿那个，就是像我这样穿防护服，戴头套、口罩，还有鞋子这种脚套呢。然后还要进来之前还要老酒精消杀，然后再来那个，因为这相当于这个还算是无菌的嘛。 这些象牙已经都清理完了，现在目前就对它就是更换10指斤，换了过后，然后还是用保鲜膜给它裹好，就免得失水嘛。失水以后，象牙是很脆弱的，它本来是有机质，失水以后呢就会疏松掉。通过修这么多呢，上千件的文物，你像那些东西自己亲手修出来的呢，你它有最完整的姿态展示给观众呢，就觉得很自豪。